everybody. To the music, but it's definitely inspiration, promotion. These nails, hallelujah. Welcome everyone, White House of Prayer. I love you. I thank you for being a part of this great move of God, increasingly available for the return, because he is coming back for his bride. Amen. Because these nails. Thus saith the Lord, stand by the ways and see and ask of the ancient path where the good way is and walk in it. You shall find rest for your soul. But he said, we will not walk. And I set a watchman over you saying, listen to the sound of the trumpet. But they said, we will not listen. Therefore, hear, O nations, and know, O congregations, what is among them. Hear, O earth, belong, and behold, I am bringing disaster on the people, the fruit of their plans, because they have not listened to my word. As for my Torah, they have rejected also. Thank you for the nails. Amen. Thank you for the nails. That's amazing. Thank you for these nails. And we are looking at the word tonight, and we want to really be comforted, but we also want to understand getting to the ancient of old and understanding what is the reality of these nails that have been used for the Messiah to hold you up. Amen. Look at Matthew chapter 5, verse 17. Never think that I have come to abolish the Torah or the prophet. I have not come to abolish, but to fulfill. This is what the problem is with us nowadays. We have to understand it's already done. Hallelujah. It's already done. For truly I say unto you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one small letter or stroke shall pass away from the Torah until it is all accomplished. That's what I stopped by here to let you know this evening. Now look thoughtfully in the way that this is pronounced to us individually and corporately. Whoever then annuls one of the least of these commandments and so teaches others shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven. Hallelujah. But whoever keeps them and touches them with the heart of compassion and teaches them to others, he shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. This was in verse 19 of Matthew. Did you understand and grasp the meaning of that being called great, acknowledging the word of God and looking upon your brethren, understanding the Sermon on the Mount? He is speaking about the commandments of Torah on the Mount. This is also what a terrible tragedy to spend one's life preaching, hallelujah, only to discover in the end that we wind up being the least in the kingdom because we annulled the true commandments of God. Hallelujah. Father, I pray for the people of your call. You've called them by name. You've entered into their space and brought them out safely, Father. Two have put 1,000 to flight, 10,000 to flight. One person saved, Father, the whole heavenly earth and heaven will celebrate. If there is be anyone, Father, that is without grace, anyone that needs a touch from you, Father, we lift them up to you this evening. I charge you in the presence of God who gives life to all things and of Messiah, Yeshua, who testified the good confession before Pontius Pilate, that you keep the commandments within stain or reproach until the appearing of the Lord Yeshua, the Messiah. 1 Timothy 6 and 13 and 14. So when we're looking at this word and we're hearing it from the spirit realm, we understand that not by might, not by power, but by your spirit. And that's how we receive it. And we confess with our mouth and believe in our heart. And that's when we start beginning to recognize that the scales are falling from our eyes. Our heart is not defensive anymore. Our heart is not hostile toward the truth. We surrender. I surrender every day of my life. I surrender. He has to give it to me. I can't do anything on my own. I am nothing without him. And even though he can reach millions and millions of people when he has a clean hands and a pure heart in his vessels, I invite you tonight to consider the things that are really important. We don't have tomorrow guaranteed. I don't have tomorrow guaranteed. I am living one day at a time, just like everybody else. And it's not always going to be easy. But then the suffering of the resurrection is the power that will withhold you and keep you a strong tower in a time of trouble. I invite you as a sister in the Lord, as a child of God, as a promise keeper, as a peacemaker. I invite you to step in and walk with me. I need the strength of my brethren and my sisters. We can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens us. But it's so much better when you have each other. It really is. And it's not about being on nobody's side. We're talking about who can be against us when God is for us. Amen. The whole world. they need to have a message of love, but that love has to be a doing love, showing the activity, the deeds of a believer is to convince the world and repair the world of the troubles that's going through. He will do it. I'm telling you, I have no other way to go but this way. I know of no other way. I've not even sought another way. I hope that you enjoyed this song and that that when we speak together, we agree on the word of God and take it by faith. And I'm going to go back into this song because these nails, them nails, that thing got in my spirit. And I was like, yeah, that is the truth. These nails that's holding me together.
Everybody say Blanche.
Going out.
Blanche is going to come. I'm going to let her sing this. This is somebody you need to look out for.
Have a good evening. Rest well.